Welcome to Savvy IT Solution. In this video, we are discussing about nested if else. In the previous videos, we are discussing about if else practically as well as a theory. Okay. In this video, we are learning about nested if else with one program example. So here, regularly I am telling you, and I need to mention very clearly that control structures under these control structures, conditional control structures under these decision making or branching under these simple if else, nested if else, and else if later. Now we are discussing about nested if else. Okay, so here the syntax is, if this condition is condition 1 is true, then condition 2 will be checked. If this is true, then statements 1 will be executed. If the condition 1 is true and condition 2 is false, then statements 2 will be executed. And now, if the condition 1 is false, then directly it goes to condition 3. If this is true, then statements 3 will be executed. If the condition 1 is false and condition 3 is false, then statement 4 will be executed. So simply, nested if else means else if within else if is used, then it is called nested if else. Okay, so simply I can say that it can be multiples, but here we are showing one if we are using one if else, one else we are using one if else. That is the simple scenario. Now this can be represented in a flow chart. So condition one, again it is condition two. So this is true, statements 1, statements 2, this is yes, this is yes, and this is no. So we connected like this. Okay, similarly this is no, condition 3, yes, no. So this is statements 3, this is statements 2 4, and we interconnected, and these two are interconnected, and finally it executes the remaining statements. So simply you can remember, this condition 1 is true, okay, it moves to right side, and if this condition is 2 is true, then statement 1 will be executed. If this condition 1 is true and condition 2 is false, then statement 2 will be executed. If this condition 1 is false, then condition 3 will be checked. If this condition 3 is true, then statements 3 will be executed. If the condition 3 is false, then statements 4 will be executed. That is the exact impact or meaning of nested if else. Okay, so I think you understand the flow chart very clearly. So now I am moving to the next step. Write a C program to find greatest of three numbers. Before discussing about already we discussed in conditional operator, but again I am repeating for better understanding. Okay, when we compare only one number to check the greatest of two numbers, obviously that number is the greatest. If you take two numbers A and B, then we need to check the condition A greater than B is enough for judging it. If the numbers are increasing, the number of conditions are increased. So if we check A and B and C, we are finding greatest of three numbers, we need to check minimum three conditions. Okay, the one is A greater than B. Next, A greater than C and B greater than C, followed by what is the result we will get. So this is what exactly we are checking in greatest of three numbers. If this condition one is true, means A greater than B is true, then we will check A greater than C. Both the conditions are true, then A is the greatest. If A greater than B is true, means A is greatest. Now we are checking A greater than C is false, then obviously C is the greatest. Okay, now A greater than B false means B is greatest. Now B greater than C is checked, if this is true, then B is greatest. And A greater than B and A B greater than C is false, then C is greatest. So this is the paradigm we are using. Instead of condition 1, we are putting A greater than B. Instead of condition 2, we are putting A greater than C. Instead of checking, condition 3, we put B greater than C. The statement 1, printf percentage D is greatest and A. Printf percentage D is greatest and C. Printf percentage D is greatest and B. Printf percentage D is greatest and C, we print automatically, it will become. So it interrelates almost all the entire syntax. So that's why we are choosing, this is the one of the best example towards the journey. So now I am checking, if A greater than B, again we need to check one more condition, if A greater than C. So we need to print f percentage D is greatest and A. Else, again we need to check one more condition, percentage D is greatest and B. So after this, now again we need to check one more condition, that is B greater than C. Okay, so printf percentage D is greatest, sorry, this is not B, this is C. Okay, and here B. Else, printf percentage D is greatest C. So this is the way we are implementing nested if else statement. Nested if else means if else within if else is used, then it is called nested if else. That is one point. Second point is, we need to, here I am using two if else, and go through the syntax as well as the flow chart. Okay, flow chart gives the more emphasis on utilizing it. Okay, in the next video we will implement the greatest of three numbers program in practically in C language. Thank you.